What's going on, everyone? Welcome back. New video on the channel, Forza Horizon 5. I actually intended to make a video today on the new car pack that's coming out to the game. It's actually coming out, I think, tonight. So, I don't actually have it yet, but I intended to make a video today on the car pack, but I completely forgot that it actually comes out kind of late in the evening. So, tomorrow, new video on the car pack that's coming out. There's going to be some interesting cars there, so keep an eye out for that video. Also, speaking of keeping an eye out for videos, I have a new video coming out on my IRL channel. It's coming out on March 1st. If you're not subscribed already, go to the description box below, click that link, and go subscribe to my IRL channel, where I'm going to be showing off a little bit of my car in real life, and also kind of going you through kind of just the, you know, the ownership, I guess, over the past 2 years. Basically what it's been like to own that car over the past few years in Ireland. So if you're interested in watching that video, then go ahead and subscribe to that channel. Anyway, I have to find out a thing, right? Let's see off the top of my head. Guys, make sure you like today's video, or I'm going to clog your toilet up tonight, and you won't be able to flush it. Is that good enough? No? That was a bit shit. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get back to the video. Wheel spin build. So, we spin a wheel spin off screen where it tells me what to build it for. You guys can't see it because it's a secret. No, it's not really a secret. It just lags every time I try to show it on the screen. So... it was almost a race build, but it landed on drift. Look at that little line. It almost landed on drift. Or on race. Okay, interesting. So we have to now build something for drifting. Well, I mean, we'll see. We'll see what we can build, especially because we're going to be doing a wheel spin build here. So whatever this picks, I have to use. I have so many wheel spins again. Okay, money is completely useless. I can't drift that. We need the car first, and then we'll spin again for the budget. In the last video, I ended up using a different wheel to show what class I should really build it for, I think it was, or something like that. And that didn't work out too well. So, in today's video, we're going to be doing it with money instead, because it makes it a little bit more interesting. Come on. Still nothing. E36 would be alright. E36 wouldn't be... Oh, the R8 would have been sick as a drift car. Could you imagine that? Come on, give me something interesting. Something that's not really supposed to be going for drifting, because that's what makes it... Oh my god, it's gonna be the Alumicraft thing, isn't... Oh, okay, no, they're not. Come on, game. Give me a car. Just anything. Anything at this point. We'll take it. We'll take it. I think I'm pretty much sorted on power. I don't know if we're gonna have the drift suspension available for this thing, but we'll take that. That's, I think, is that the first? Maybe not, because I've done a lot of videos on this, but that could be the very first Forza Edition car that we've gotten for our wheel spin build on Forza Horizon 5. Add it to garage, and then now be spin for the budget. Minimum 20k. Okay, we pretty much have an unlimited budget in this car to build up. that's such a random car to get. Honestly. I've never done a build on this car before. I don't think I've ever even driven this car before. I think the only reason why this doesn't say new next to it is because I think I ended up going into it and using the car mastery to try and unlock maybe some money or whatever it is that's available in it. I'll have a look actually if there is anything, because if there is, we could probably get our money back. Even from the... Oh my god, we get a super wheel spin as well from this. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. There you go. We'll just spin this as well, because why not? Doesn't really mean anything. Some 4-star points, and then we have some money. Okay, sick. Well, this has been an interesting car to get. Oh, I like this already. It's not particularly powerful. It does have a fire speed. Yeah, it's not particularly powerful stock. It's just at the top of A class. We have an unlimited budget on this thing, so we could probably get this thing to be quite a fun little car to drive. We don't have any engine swaps available. Interesting. But we can supercharge it. which I'm definitely down to do. Already front engine rear wheel drive, so I'm not going to be touching that at all. What? Oh, that's just not the bonnet though, is it? No, I don't want to change that. Wait, do I want to change that? Nah. It looks cooler like that. We'll keep it, we'll keep it, we'll keep it. As for the tires, we're going to go some snow tires on this thing. Whoa. Wait, that's actually kind of cool. It still has the... Which was this? So, apart from the drift tires, and the fully slick tires, even some semi-slick tires. Wait, what? That's sick, though. The snow tires actually still have the writing on it, where it says Forza Edition. These off-road tires do as well. Oh, that's sick. That makes it even better. That makes it even better. Let's give it some bigger wheels, though. 19s. Yeah, let's go 19s all around. Again, unlimited budget. It just doesn't really matter now, does it? What we built this thing like. For the wheels, I don't know if I want those wheels on it, to be completely honest with you. Ooh. I love how I immediately just go to work wheels, because there's so many of them that look good on a lot of different types of cars. I shouldn't really mind these at all. I think I've picked these in the past, though, on different builds, but these look good. I love a little bit of a deep dish type of vibe with this thing. I think that's nice. I'm going to go with the race transmission and, of course, race diff. Actually, we'll go with the off-road diff because that just locks my diff. And then I don't have to do anything to it. Suspension. Drift suspension. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And everything else, I'm just going to give it more power, I guess. I mean, it's already got 600 and something horsepower. So a lot, it's not like this thing's a... I mean, even NA, we could have probably kept it. It's over 1,000 horsepower. I don't know if having over 1,000 horsepower on snow tires is a good idea, but we'll try it. I'll try it like that. Okay. What a weird spec. I mean, power to weight ratio is mad on this thing. It's better than a 1-to-1 power to weight ratio, which is sick. What a very, very strange car to get as our build. For today. I'm gonna stretch my gears out, because this thing has a lot of power, so I feel like it's gonna run through these gears pretty easily. Alright then, let's try it out. See if it's any use. It looks really good though, I really like this paint. I mean, I know I'm off-road, but like... Jesus. Let's try to get on the actual road itself. What it's like grip wise. It is about as it is about as rowdy as I expected it to be. It is about as rowdy as I expected it to be. Fourth and fifth are absolutely killing it though. It's very good. No, it's good. It is very good, actually. Let's jump over to your side. There we go. Ooh. The supercharger whine. Oh my god. Oh man, this is a handful. But like a good type of handful. Oh, it's gone. Alright, so to change things up a little bit, I thought we could go ahead and try and find a random track to go on. I literally just went into the PG editor's choice. And I just picked the first one that it looked interesting. This is also made for drifting, so it should be quite fun. Okay. What are we looking at here? Wait, what? I thought that was the entrance. Wait, what? did he make us? Am I stupid? I'm blind. I think I'm stupid and also blind. Oh wait, no, we have the dragon right now. I'm definitely stupid. Okay, okay. I like the little pit area. This is nice. Alright, so to exit, you just go there. Wait, is this it? Boy, this is nice. Boy, this is really nice, actually. This has way too much power for the strike. I need to be in just second gear, just driving around. This thing has way too much power for the strike. Oh, there goes the decor. See what I mean? That's the kind of speed that I should really be going at, but... It just puts it into perspective when you have cars like this with an unlimited budget. But it's nice because it kind of makes you change speed quite a lot. Make sure you use your handbrake quite a bit as well. I actually quite like this track. The car itself is really smooth. What a sick track. Genuinely, it's such a nice little track, like, to go on. It's very smooth the way it's built. We got a nice couple of variations of corners here. Oh, I can't wait for reverse entry in this thing. That's just not gonna happen. Alright, let's change our view a little bit. Let's go to first person, see what's happening over here, first person. I can't see anything. After I knock the stuff down. I mean, the car is fun, I can't let loose in it too much, if that makes sense. Oh my god. Third is just not a good gear for this, it's just too long. There's very few corners in third that I'm actually able to do anything. I need to slow down so much for some of these corners, and keeping it in third, especially with my wheels spinning so fast, it's just not it. That's why second is definitely the best gear to use for this track, which means having 1100 horsepower is completely pointless on this track. I definitely picked the wrong track for this car, but then again, how was I supposed to know what this track is going to be like? Regardless, though, you just get to see how smooth my drifting is. It's not too bad, is it, with this car? You can see how close I can get the objects in that. Try to get nice across that wall. It's not too bad. There you go, see? If I'm smooth with it, I can be very consistent. Kind of a understeer there, actually. Had to slow down quite a lot, that's probably why. But apart from that, this is a lovely track. No, I tapped off the wall. Or tires, whatever.
after a while, but all the way to 5th. It is lovely to drive. I think I'm more impressed with the track than I am with the car. I'm gonna be honest with you. I actually really like this track. I found an absolute gem of a track. But this would be really fun to tandem on, but I don't know if he has a PvP version of this thing. I mean, obviously what I picked the just whatever was in the editor's choice thing. And do we just go out here now? I'm just gonna drift in the pits. Screw it. Who's gonna stop me? And I think once you're done, you just drive in here. Am I right? That is sick. That's a good track. That is a really, really good track. I genuinely enjoy that. I genuinely enjoy that track. Is there a way to like it? Yes, I will. I'll give that a like. That was sick. Well, everyone, I guess that's pretty much it for today's video on the little Corvette. It seems to be a really, really smooth drift car. Like I said, the thing is, as you can see, the thing is with it is that it's got a lot of power, so you don't really need a lot of it on that track. What you do need with it is lots of control, though, especially when you're driving really low speeds. Lots of throttle control, especially in second. But apart from that, it's one smooth car to slide with. In pretty much any gear that you want. It's lovely. Props to all the people making the new maps, though, over here on the new on this new island. Because genuinely, they all look really, really good. People are making like some seriously nice looking maps. Oh my god, I actually got a reverse entry out of that. Yeah, people are making some really, really nice maps here. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. I think we're only going to do one car for today's video, because I think I spent a lot of time just sliding around with this car, because I really enjoyed it. But that was a very smooth drift car on a very, very cool track. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone, and I guess I'll see you in the next video. And goodbye. And